Joe Barton is coming out to the mound. And they're going to have a little chat.
I think we're going to make a pitching change.
Yeah.
The right field bullpen door has opened. He's having a chat with Walker at the mound. Richmond on a knee. I'd be tired too after that. I thought for a second he was going to score.
When that relay throw came up short and the third baseman had to go chase it down, it looked like he might make a run for it, but he was pretty gassed. He eased up into third base there.
Barton makes the change. Walker out, and we have a new pitcher on the mound. We'll get a name to go with that face. Both teams pretty much on the top step of the dugout here, of their respective dugouts, taking it all in.
We only get 7 innings out here every year. You know, try to get the most out of the experience.
Yep, absolutely.
Even if you're not playing.
So Richmond 3-for-3 on the night. And each year you go into this game thinking who's going to be, you know, one of the guys to watch. And his name's always at the top of everybody's list.
After that rough start, a couple runs in the first, really settled in, 4 straight goose eggs on the board, and really picking up his strikeouts, his 6 strikeouts.
He had 6, yep.
5 innings of work. As you mentioned, 3-for-3. He scored twice. He's sitting at third with nobody out here in the bottom of the fifth. Already a 5-run cushion for the Democrats.
And we have a name to go with that face on the pitching mound, Dave McConnell.
Yeah.
Pat Meehan. Meehan.
All right.
He's going to relieve Walker. And his first batter he will face is Tim Ryan. So Meehan from the stretch, first offering to Ryan inside.
Barton is high on this guy. He said he was exceptional at a recent scrimmage. He looks sharp on the mound. Meehan is mature, shall we say, in his age category. He's 61, and he first entered the house back in 2011. So we'll see what kind of stuff he can produce tonight.
He's fallen behind 3-0 to his first batter in Tim Ryan.
Pat Meehan, the Pennsylvania 7th.
Here's the 3-0 swing. Miss. Fastball up high.
5-run lead. I guess you get a green light on
3-0
in this
game. You get a green light on 3-0. A 3-1 for Meehan coming up. Nope, Ryan's going to step out. I can't really make out the jersey. Can you, Noah? What is he? What jersey is Tim Ryan wearing? Do you know?
I can't pick it up.
Can't either. Yeah. Here's the 3-1, ball 4. He dropped his bat. Just saying. Ball 4. You've seen it before. All right, fine, not here. By the way, I must say, we have to give also a special shout-out to part of our research department and Chris Cheon.
Exactly.
Helping out with the notes tonight.
Yeah, he's really great with my prepared ad-libs. Huh?
That's right. Chris Cheon back at the WTOP Studios is in the our crack research department. Ryan walks down to first.
Of course, Chris can be heard weekends on WTOP Sports. When George is at home resting.
Strike 1 call on the outside corner.
So I may have an answer for you. Ryan had a Y on his jersey. He's from Ohio.
Okay.
Maybe the Youngstown area. That's his district.
All right.
Youngstown to Akron.
The 0-1 swinging a little looper back to me, and he up with it. Throws over to first, but it gets behind Rooney. Almost hits the runner. And he's going to come all the way around to score.
There's a heavy collision at first base. Right as the ball got there.
Is he okay?
Looks like it. Headed into second. Cardenas came all the way around to score.
Cardenas came all the way around to score after the walk. At the pinch runner. And Polis ends up at second. And we'll get a pinch runner there as well. Meehan had to rush the throw. It would have taken a perfect throw, but also when you're running down the first baseline, not necessarily if he was on the right side of the line.
It tailed on him a little bit back into the base runner, too.
We're going to have our first pinch hitter of the day.
It's Dan Kildee in now. Took over for his uncle, Dale Kildee, longtime Michigan congressman.
Are you scoring? What are you scoring that, Noah? You won?
It's a tough play. I don't know.
Is he going to beat it out?
It's close.
We don't want to be too hard on these guys.
Either way, there's an error in him advancing. But it's a matter of whether or not you want to credit him with a hit.
Dave, what do you think? Runner takes off for third. Kildee lets it go for a strike. And Polis down to third.
Kildee is very big on this game. He said it's great we can get together. And it comes at an especially important time that we demonstrate that the divisions can be breached. And our game will be one way to show it.
Meehan gets his first strikeout as Kildee goes down swinging. And coming to the plate now to a standing ovation. Linda Sanchez.
That Linda finally makes her appearance.
Crouching down for the right side. Ball one.
She's not out there looking for a walk, I can tell you that much.
Ball two. The chant of Linda from the Democratic side of the ballpark, which is right below us. Meehan's 2-0 offering. Strike on the outside corner. Of course, nobody liked that one.
Let's see if she gets something to hit 3-0.
She have the green light? She ducks. Oh, a strike on the inside corner. She tossed her bat, thinking it was ball four. And she's got words for the home plate umpire. Why not? It's 9-2.
Another chance to swing the bat here.
3-1 to Sanchez. As she stands in. Polis at third. Meehan's going to go from the windup. He's into the wind. Here comes the 3-1. Over her head. Ball four. No? And now she's got words for the umpire. What happened? Did it hit her bat?
What happened?
3-2, it must have hit her back.
Oh, wow. Sorry, she says it's all right. Waves her manager back to the dugout.
It must have hit her bat. Well, she crouches down, and she didn't get the bat out of the way. So here comes the 3-2, the biggest drama of the night. Linda Sanchez at the plate. The 3-2 from Meehan into the wind. Fastball outside, ball four. A pinch runner at first base. Hakeem Jeffries will pinch run for Linda Sanchez as she comes around behind home plate back to the dugout to a nice standing ovation from the Democratic side of the ballpark right above her dugout. Ed Perlmutter, Dave, is now batting. Strike on the corner, and Jeffries takes second.
Perlmutter is from Colorado, represents the 7th District.
We're seeing all the bench this inning. Three straight pinch hitters for the Democrats.
Meehan into the windup, the 0-1. Ball outside, ball two. 1-1, I should say. Ball one. Meehan working quickly as well.
Perlmutter's with the math guys on financial
services. Ball gets by Davis. Wild pitch. And Polis comes in to score. The 10th run of the game for the Democrats. It's now 10-2 on the fastball.
This is turning into a rout.
That is accurate.
It would be hard to beat last year's game.
Yeah.
But this one was close for a while. But the third multi-run inning.
Swing and a miss. Don't know what he's swinging at there. Ball high and outside.
Third inning of three or more runs, for that matter, for the Democrats. Three in the first, four in the third. Three and counting here with one out in the fifth.
As Meehan into the wind. Jeffries dances off third. Swing and a foul.
Akeem Jeffries from the great state of New York. On third base.
He's taking a pretty healthy lead with the pitcher Stan on the windup.
Perlmutter swings and pops it up down the first baseline. Rooney over, gets a glove on it, falls down, can't make the catch. Is he okay? He is still down along the first baseline. Did it hit him in the face?
He looks a little shaken up. Couldn't tell if that was disappointment or injury.
I thought at first it was disappointment. The trainer's out now to take a look at it. We'll see if we can get a replay. As Rooney went over for that ball in foul territory, got under it.
Got a glove on it, but couldn't squeeze it. Shakes it off. He's back on his feet.
Maybe more upset at himself that he didn't catch the ball.
Yeah.
And Jeffries had an eye on that. He was thinking about tagging and coming home from third if he did catch it. So might have actually been a blessing in disguise.
So Perlmutter stands in, still has life. 2-2, one out. Jeffries at third. Well, actually, is Rooney going to come out of the game? He's going to come out of the game.
Tried to stay in, but no sense in pushing this.
We'll see who replaces him at first base, but Thomas Rooney going to come out of the game in the first base dugout after got hit with the ball on that pop-up. Meanwhile, Perlmutter stands in at ball three now, 3-2. Jeffries dancing off third. Meehan looking in. He's got the sign from Davis. The windup and the pitch bounces at ball four.
I wonder where Perlmutter is going with that bat, George.
Mike Conway, it looks like, is going to Mike Conway goes in at first, and we've got another pinch hitter.
Nanette. Another lady player.
And she swings and sends the ground ball to third. Kelly picks it up, throws to first. Not in time. She's safe. And a run scores. Nanette, first pitch swinging, drives in a run, and the crowd goes crazy. It's 11-2, Democrats lead.
For the record, Nanette Diaz-Barragan from the California 44th. This is her first congressional baseball game. Pardon me. She also plays in the Congressional Women's Softball game, but she's off to a great start here.
I would say so, and she's got a full Dodgers uniform on.
And for years, Linda Sanchez was the only woman who played in this game. I'm sure she had a word or two in recruiting a fellow Southern California fan.
Yeah.
We go to the bench again. Mark Vizi. Vizi will pinch hit now for Susie. Four runs home, 11-2. Runners at first and second.
Beasley's from the Texas 33rd.
Perlmutter at second. Nanette at first. Beasley at the plate. Meehan from the stretch now. Curveball. Missed the plate, 2-0. The 2-0 offering behind him, ball three, 3-0.
He's on the Armed Services, Science, Space, and Technology. Represents the Dallas region. Mark Beasley.
The 3-0 over for a strike. Doesn't have the green light on 3-0 here. Meehan into the stretch, the 1-1. Strike two.
All right.
Republicans need outs. Meehan comes set. He 3-2 to Beasley. High, ball four, walks him. Bases loaded.
That is the danger in this game. It can slow down if people can't find the strike zone. It's the toughest part of baseball in terms of the skill level to be able to get out there and throw strikes. And you see Joe Barton out here make another mound visit.
Bottom of the fifth inning, four runs in. Bases loaded. This is a seven-inning game. Barton calling for the right-hander out of the bullpen.
Another conference out on the mound with Joe Barton. And this time.
So, Noah, explain now what Dave was talking about before. What is this conversation now?
I mean, it looks like he's just trying to calm him down. It looked like he might make a move. I saw some movement toward the bullpen gate, but did not actually make a call for a relief pitcher, you know. Like, he just tried to get out there, break up the rhythm a little bit.
Yeah.
In steps Raul Ruiz, top of the order. Ruiz a single and three trips to the plate tonight. He's also scored a run. He scored the first run of the game. Bottom of the fifth inning, 11-2, Democrats lead.
Ruiz from the California 36th.
Here's the 1-0, ball high, ball too high. Meehan can't find the plate now.
That is the danger. Go to the bullpen. Go to your second best pitcher who hasn't thrown in a year.
There's a swing by Ruiz and a hot shot to center. Jeff Flake line drive catches it.
And the runner came streaking home from third. Still does not realize.
Perlmutter did not tag. They're going to double him up at third. He's out. Nice job of Ryan Costello noticing that he had not tagged up. And he tags him up, doubles him up. And that gets the Republicans out of the inning in a big way.
Wow.
That was the slowest developing F865 double play you've ever seen in your life.
Four runs on three hits, and they leave two on. We go to the sixth. It's an 11-2 Democrats lead. You're listening to Congressional Baseball Game on Federal News Radio.